Okay, so the yesterday's class we have seen how we can put lights and materials and then render it. So we have this render setup. The shortcut is F10. So you can press F10 as well. So here we have discussed about this target, production rendering and active sheet. And then when you need a still image, so then you will use this single option. If you need to render the animation, then you will choose this active time segment. All right, then, or if you want to render the part of your some part, not only not the full animation, only few part from the animation, then you will choose the range option. And you can set it to zero, from 0 to 50. That's like that you can choose. And you can render per frames as a still image, that you can also do. So there you can select frames. Okay, so these are the options. So let's see active time segment and area to render. Area to render, we use view most of the time. So particular view you can render. So for that, like this quad 4 or perspective viewport is right now selected. So that view, that perspective view, or if you are in camera view, so that camera view will be rendered. You can select as region. So region is for particular area. So you can define that particular area only to be rendered. Suppose this particular area will be only rendered. So according to that, you have to set region. Okay. And what will be the output size? So there you can define it as per the ratio. Okay. So here some pre-settings are there. So according to that, you can set it. Okay. So you can go with custom and there you can set it, or from width you can go for 198, 1980 by 2700. Okay, so this way you can set the output size. And these options, atmospheres, effects, displacement, that is checked. If you want to, like you have make hidden some geometric some objects, so you want to render those without bringing those back into your scene, so you want to render those. So for that you will choose this. Okay, let's go for this advanced lighting. This is okay for use advanced lighting. This will be checked, and let's go for this render output. So for that you need to save the file. Most of the time we don't save the file, we just rendered it to check the render here, and we don't save it. So for that, check on this save file, and here you can save it. So what will be the format? So if you are saving it as PNG or JPEG file, so you save that as type and give the file name, and with that file name it will be saved. Okay, so there are some file types. This .avi, when you will render animation as a video, so for that you have to select .avi, so then only it will be saved as a video format. Okay, and BMP for image file, like a raster image. You save it as a raster image. And we have some other options like Targa image file, TIF image file. Those are some image files. You can save those. Sorry. Yes. So this BMP files are is there. So that is a still image file, and targa, as I was mentioning, targa image file is there. So that format was developed by True Vision for their video boards. The format supports 32-bit true color, that is 24-bit color plus an alpha channel, and it is typically used as a true color format. And TIFF is there. TIFF is there. So that is tagged image file format. This is a multi-platform bitmap format originating on the Macintosh and desktop publishing application. So TIFF is a common choice if you plan to send your output to a print service bureau or import the image into a page layout program. Okay, and GIF is also there. So GIF, GIF should be there. GIF used to be there. Okay, no problem, it's not present. So these are the file types. So most of the cases we use JPEG or PNG. And if you want your animation file per frame as an image, so then you can use this TIFF image file or your targa image file that you can use. Okay. And if you are choosing AVI file format, so that you can use. Okay, and when you save it, let's give it a name X. This AVI file compression setup will be appeared, and then you have to choose the same compressor, that is Microsoft Video One, and you can give the quality. Okay, as per that, you'll get a better quality. Okay, so that you can do, and go to, I'm going to cancel it, and you can cancel it. So these are the settings you'll have to mention it, and then let's go for this file, and here we got this export option. So you go to export, and you can export your 3ds Max file as a DWG file, as a AutoCAD file. You can export it. You can export as a DXF file. DXF is data exchange format file. So that file is for all the CAD software, okay, which even doesn't support DWG format, so like SolidWorks, CATIA, that kind of CAD softwares support DXF. So you can save that as DXF. Okay, for Illustrator you can do that, and 3D Studio, I have already mentioned that it was applicable for DOS format. So for DOS format there is 3D Studio, so you can export it as a 3ds .3ds. And what is the 3ds Max, Windows 3ds Max format? That is .max. .max is the format. When you'll save the file, generally you'll get .max. Okay, so you can save it as FBX. FBX, that is for all the BIM software, or all the softwares supports FBX. So your Revit also support FBX, so you can export it into FBX, and you can import it into your Revit file so that you can open it. It doesn't Revit doesn't support .max file, so Autodesk FBX, you can save it as Navisworks cache file, so that you can run into Navisworks. So you can get your 4D simulation there. You can do that. So these are the file formats. and let's go to the render setup and let's change it to single and go to this view. Go to this view, and I already have mentioned about project, so you can create a default project, and there, or every time whenever you will save it, you will only save into that folder. You can create first your folder. Okay, so let me show you the default folder, and into the desktop, let me create new one folder. Let's give it with my name. And go to project and create default. And you can go to desktop, and here this is there. So there is nothing, okay? But if you select this, go to select folder. And now let me show you. So this is the folder. Now everything has been created. So in this scene, your project will be saved. This auto backup files has been created. So this way you will create, okay, scene assets, all the materials will be loaded here, images will be saved in this file. So we will get all the files sorted here into this. So these are the things you should follow. And I have already completed about preferences. So that you go to this customize and preference, that's same settings. And this is all your file setup. You will export, or you can save as your files into a particular folder and different format. You can save it, you can render your files. So that's all about today's class. So I hope you can export a nice rendered file as a .max file. You can create a new project in 3ds Max. So I'll give you a simple task to create a living room, interior living room, where all the furnitures will be there, like three-seater sofa, a center table, TV unit. You can place flower vase. So you can go with some simple ones and place materials over there and render it. And if you want to create animation, you can create animation and you can render it. So go with these projects. Try with yourself. Okay, and please check with me. I will check and I'll tell you if there is anything better you can do, or if you have done correct. So please check with me. All right then, guys, if you have any queries, you can ask me.
No, sir, nothing.
Okay, so Sai Krishna is present, Rudviraj. And Jayasri. Okay, so thank you guys.
Sir, you just
Yes.
told how to export and import in Nepal.
Right.
Now you
Yes.
explained only regarding importing and exporting the files of how to save and how to render, how to copy the files, only that one. And you gave a task to create a small room with a furniture, with a small furniture within this 3 days max.
Right.
Or we should do it in AutoCAD and we have to export it, import in 3 days max and making it easy model. Do you mean that?
No, create in 3ds Max.
Okay, sir.
Yes, if you have already done in AutoCAD, then you can import that and you can render it. That file you just render it with applying materials. That is a separate task. If it is available, that AutoCAD file is available to you, that you can do as a separate task.
As I have only a walls and walls, not a good, I just placed the walls and windows, that's it, sir. Not a furniture tools.
Okay, so in Revit, if it is there, so you can import Revit file as well. So for
Yes,
that,
yes.
yes, this we go to this import and link Revit is there. Same like link AutoCAD, it will work.
Okay.
Revit. So you can work with your existing Revit file as well. But try with once at least one small project like a living room or a bedroom at least. Bedroom will be very much easier for you. You can go with bedroom as well.
We can create a walls and windows within places. How can we place those furniture parts? Like we have to create the family look. We have to create that family too, right, sir?
In Revit there is family, but here it is not called family. It is normal object. The first or the second class I have showed you about poly modeling, the creating the sofa. So that
Ah,
way,
yes.
yes, that way
Okay.
and. Creating the fan, that way you will create all your furniture and all your model and you will
Got it.
place. Yes.
I have an idea, sir. Upload that videos in AutoCAD. Who is maybe I don't know in charge? I think Swiggy, sir. I think.
Okay.
Upload that video. Up to now, upload that videos in AutoCAD. We can go through it easily because AutoCAD file is visible for us. Only one
AutoCAD.
file in. We have only
Okay.
one file in AutoCAD.
AutoCAD videos are not uploaded yet.
No, actually, at that time, firstly, we started AutoCAD. At that time, recordings are not happened, not started, and we don't have any Pocket Study app over that time.
Okay.
So in AutoCAD, we have only one file. It's not a problem. If they
Okay.
apply, if they upload those all these all 3 days max in AutoCAD, we can easily go through it.
Okay. So, what I can do is, if you give me your email address now, I can send it
Yes.
to you via email. All the video files is available to me, so I can send it to via email also.
Okay, sir. I can even
Okay,
write,
sir.
even I can send it in chat box.
Yeah, you guys, please send your email address, okay, to me in WhatsApp. Send your email address. I'll send it to you within tomorrow. All the video
I'll
file.
send you to the chat box, meeting chat.
Okay. No. In the WhatsApp, if you do it, so
Okay, sir.
share it with me in WhatsApp.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
It would be maybe a big task for you, sir. If they upload those videos in AutoCAD, it's not a big problem for them and you and for us too.
Yes, I have uploaded the 3ds Max files and AutoCAD files. I'm taking right now the AutoCAD class for Batch Gold. So those files I can share with you as well.
No, nothing. Don't need
Or
those. Yeah.
yes, I will definitely share the 3ds Max video files with you. And let
Okay.
me talk with Mr. Suvigya and I'll ask him to share your batch AutoCAD files if it is available to him, or else let me talk with him and I'll
No,
share.
sir. I'm asking to share the 3ds Max videos in AutoCAD. because in our AutoCAD we have only one video, because we didn't save any videos regarding our classes.
Okay, in 3ds Max
So no
for
problem, sir. Just send it to my mail, sir. Just send it to
mail.
me.
Yes, you can send it through mail. Not a problem. Okay, sir.
Okay, so the 3ds Max video files, I'll send it to you. And I
Yeah.
didn't
Okay,
get
sir.
that point that your AutoCAD file
Okay,
sorry.
so okay, sir. Not a problem, sir. You better to send to mail is the best one, sir.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
All right then, and definitely please, I'm requesting you guys that please definitely do practice. If it is not possible right now, even that's not a problem. Even after that, whenever you get time, please do practice and please solve all your queries and better result. If you show me some outputs, I'll be very much happier.
Okay,
Okay,
sir.
sir. Okay.